Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm talking fat transfer. Why wouldn't you just get fat transferred to the areas of the face or the body where you want rejuvenation? We want volume. Maybe it's less expensive. It's all natural. Why wouldn't you just do that? And the particular question I got asked was with the lip filler. Why wouldn't we use fat or fat transfer to the lip? And a lot of people think it's because of the money, because people want to make money off of the fillers, or there's more revenue involved. But fat transfer in and of itself often makes more money and has the highest revenue for a practice, because there is no cost to the practice or the physician, and they can charge then solely for their time. A lot of times for a practice, one of the most expensive parts or their biggest expense will be the fillers, the neuromodulators, and everything they buy. So let's go through the positives and benefits. Number one for fat would be it's all natural. We know foreign body nodules, bumps, lumps, or infections occur, but fat's all natural, and that would be one benefit. Number two is fat would be free to the patient or to the person getting it. You can just take it from somewhere else in the body and move it around. So why wouldn't you do it? It does make sense, and sometimes there's plenty of it. Number three is there wouldn't be migration. We talked about lip filler migration in another video I did. Fat wouldn't migrate because it's part of the body and all natural, so you wouldn't have to worry about that. Another benefit could be that it's permanent. So the fat that takes would last for possibly ever. Sure, there's facial aging that occurs or body aging that occurs. People might want to fine tune over time, but a permanent component, that certainly would be nice. Finally, if you want a lot of volume, if you're doing a buttock or a breast where you need more volume, a lot of people have that volume. And the benefit is you can take it from a belly or love handles or the back where they don't want the volume, and you could move it to where you do want the volume. And a lot of people don't want breast implants because of the problems of foreign body, the implication of cancers, and so on. So why don't I use it? Why am I not that big a proponent of doing it? I'm going to give you the reasons against, and many people don't factor these in because they're not as intuitive as the reasons for doing it. Let's go through number one. To get fat, you need a harvest site. So let's say you come in, you want facial volume, you want fat. I got to take that fat from somewhere. For people who just want the face or maybe the lip, we would take that from the lower belly, maybe the back. But let's say we took 10 or 20 mLs, let's just say a couple tablespoons at least, often a lot more. You would have a defect of that somewhere in the body, especially if you don't carry a lot of weight. So you need a harvest site, and there could be scars associated with that. Usually it can be done through a small opening, but there still might be some small scar that would then produce. Number two is that fat, great, we take it from somewhere, but it has to live, it has to revascularize. And so what's that percentage? A lot of times it can be as low as 40 to 60%, depending on where we're talking, to as high as 80 to 90%. But imagine if we were only 80 or to 90% precise under an eye, in a lip, where that extra 10%, that makes a big difference. You can be much more precise with filler. And there's other factors that deal with the viability of the fat. For instance, if you move it to the buttock, a lot of people can't sit on that for up to 6 weeks until that vascularization occurs. The blood flow has to go to the fat. You get that blood flow and it lives. So there's a variability there with that. Let's say that it didn't all take and you wanted a touch up. You would have to then go back, harvest the fat again. You take it out, you spin it down. Sometimes you might add PRF or PRP to it, different things you can do to the fat to make it better. But you would need a whole other procedure. If you were getting filler or biostimulators, that's already packaged. And then all the what we already talked about, the harvest site, the possible scarring, you'd have to go through that again. So that adds a negative towards transferring fat, particularly to the face, lip, or temples. The next thing is, a lot of people would say, well, yes, it is natural, so they don't think that there could be side effects. However, with fat transfer to the buttock, there's a 1 in 1300 with the traditional methods of death from the pieces of fat going up to the lungs, what we call a pulmonary embolus. And people now know and consider blindness with fillers. Many of the cases of blindness we know come from fat and fat transfer. So it can cause a lot of side effects. It's not like moving fat around doesn't have its own side effects. So those are some, just a few of the things to consider when we consider about fat. What I wanted to do is look at the lip, because the question I got was, why wouldn't you put it in the lips? And intuitively, it makes a lot of sense, because the lip, we want it soft, fat is soft. We don't need a lot of product. We only use 1 or 2 mLs of filler in the lip anyway. And we don't like foreign bodies in the lip, because fillers can look lumpy, bumpy, and a little unnatural. So it does make sense. But let's look at the lip to find out. Here is a cross section of the lip. You can see there's almost no fat in the lip. Most of it is muscle. So if we were to take 4 cc's of fat, remember we use about 1 cc of filler per patient, and we might repeat that certainly at 3 to 5 months. But let's take, we overfill the lip with fat, because we're gonna say, we're gonna try and get 70% to take, 30% is gonna die off, maybe even 50. The reason is, why almost all of it goes away when you transfer it, is there's not a lot of blood flow to the lip. And so there's no revascularization. The fat doesn't live. Some people do certainly do this procedure, but that's why 99% of fillers are done with hyaluronic acid fillers. It's not because drug companies or people trying to make money. It's just that fat is an imprecise product to use in the lip that often doesn't take. But it is a great thought. And I thought, what a great question, because you would think that fat transfer would be more popular to the lip. But that's probably the number one reason why. And while people are waiting to see how much fat takes, of course, you have to overfill the lip with fat. So it's gonna look unnatural for a while, till the fat that's gonna die off goes. And let's say you wanted a little touch-up, you would then need to really get filler to precisely touch up the areas where the fat did not take. So tell me, have you had fat transfer done? It works much better for the buttocks and the breast than it would for the face or the lip. It can be done, some people do it. Do you like it? I put a whole playlist up here on biostimulators and collagen-like products, so you can see what an alternative to fillers and facial fat might be if you want global volumization. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.